anything in a visual medium is kind of based around light hitting a surface of material and kind of getting into your eye. So I think light does have this kind of innate attraction.
This work, it's called Walk, and people have to move around it, or they will move here in the fair and they will see it from every angle. It's different. So if you're really near, you feel the breeze of the work and the light. And if you're more in a distance, you see different images, different clues. You see the pixels, 5,000, and in each pixel are 7 LEDs. And it's like television, so it's green and blue and red. And so 60 million colors you can make by it. And these are strings, and I put them all together in this sphere. What's interesting in the light is actually it's invisible, so you always need an aura reflection. But the most important thing is the space in between. So that's why you can work with time and motion and energy. That's why I'm working with light. It's just great.
I work with all sorts of things, from colour changing inks which react to sunlight to more modern technology such as polymer opal, which actually reacts to stretch, and that's part of nanotechnology. It's based on the idea of colour being used as diffraction rather than absorption of light. And these sorts of technologies are all suitable for different clothing depending on what you want. All the technology which is used in the garment is meant to make the material perform and to be special. I see the entertainment industry as a playground for exploring concepts. So I see performers using it, and then I also see it being used in merchandise. I don't see it in ready to wear completely just yet, but I think that will follow. I use technology almost like a painter's palette. So that's why I experiment with lots of different technologies rather than using technology just for the sake of it, because I don't want it to be gimmicky. It needs to be beautiful and then kind of have an extra gloss layer.
The work is kind of innately ephemeral and sort of transient. Each one's kind of built to a specific space, and it's up there for a while and then it's gone. I quite like the idea of them being very temporary things. Almost like kind of quick gestural sort of mark making. Space is always sort of one of the key components of the work. And I think again it's this property of light, of it manipulating the environment, sort of filling an environment. The space becomes a kind of container of the light almost. It's really kind of simple materials. It's basically fishing line, like nylon fishing line, which is kind of strung across the space in grids to get a kind of strict geometry, and then that's illuminated with these ultraviolet LED panels which you can kind of focus down these beams of light and create this glowing kind of geometric prism thing. But a lot of these things come from initial drawings, so it kind of feels a bit like that, like you're taking a line and following these sort of grid-like patterns, but rather than on a flat surface, it's across a space.
We think that looking at nature is very, very important, and not just as a formal way, but really looking at the systematic ideas in nature and trying to grasp the logic of systems in nature in order to build more intelligently and in a more integrated manner.
Imagine having a long day at work and you come back and you just want to have a different environment where you walk into your house. And you can do that by actually changing how you see the space, while you can change the mapping to create a different type of environment. And you don't have to actually move any furniture around. You just have your interface device, and simply by options you have already created, you can give yourself the opportunity to have a different feeling.
Technology is actually the force behind all of these experiments we are doing right now, because both from the side of the computational paradigm and also fabrication paradigm, and how the simulation world and the physical world, how they start to talk to each other, that happens with technology, which you could never imagine in the past.